Darwinism has to do with the fact that species which are successful are fit. They survive their environment and they produce offspring. Turns out in quantum mechanics, you can understand emergence of things which are stable and therefore candidates for things which are classical using essentially Darwin's ideas. First of all, they should be stable in spite of what the environment is trying to do to them. And that idea presages quantum Darwinism. That's really the heart of decoherence. But what happens actually, and you know, it happens right now, is that this environment, which in decoherence is just a place where you hide uncomfortably quantum information, is actually not the place where you hide, but it's sort of like a big advertising billboard for the information that you can acquire. So, for example, right now, you're looking at me, I'm looking at you. We are both bathed in a photon environment. That photon environment bounces off me, it bounces off you, we see each other. Not by some sort of direct interaction, but simply because we intercept part of the environment which decoheres us, and we use it as a communication channel. So there are multiple copies of the useful information about us and everything else in that environment. So that information about these stable states gets multiplied, proliferates. Stable states spawn information theoretic copies that are all over the place. So this is the proliferation of the species, a la Darwin. And using these sorts of ideas, you can understand better how classicality comes out of quantum substrate. I mean, the big puzzle, the underlying puzzle of interpretation of quantum mechanics is that we believe all of the universe is made out of quantum stuff. If all of the universe is made out of quantum stuff, everything should behave quantumly. And yet, things we encounter on a daily basis don't do things quantum things do. They aren't in two places at once and so on. And understanding why that doesn't happen has been a puzzle. Decoherence helped because it said that certain states are more stable than others. Quantum Darwinism goes a step beyond that because it says that using means that we use for perception, that is indirect measurements via photons and environments, we are restricted. We are forced to see things which end up having multiple copies, and these are the things which can survive for a long time. It has to be consistent with decoherence, but there is more.